Great Scott! Ah!
Oh, don't fall!
Do you not realize we're in the middle of a parking lot? Didn't I leave you in 1992, Doc? No, and don't touch my book.
Yes, Marty! But I walked all the way back.
You're telling me you walked from 1992 to 2007?
Well, I biked a little.
You really don't even make sense anymore, but whatever.
Are you writing on the molecular mechanics of time travel? Or perhaps yes?
No.
How your Buick has a unique hood that opens forward instead of up.
No, I'm writing on the clock tower downtown and how the lightning strikes hit it and wore it out or broke it, I guess, and whatever.
That's the power! That's the power! I'm sorry, Marty. I was testing my brain waves with this device.
You mean my MP3 player? How did things ever go with that Dance Mix 92 tape?
You know, it turns out it was broken after all. Yeah, for the life of me, I couldn't get it to play in the Buick's cassette deck.
Well, there is just a CD player in there.
Yes!
Okay, I meant to ask you though, how did you manage to turn my Buick into a time machine anyways?
It's really quite simple, Mahati.
It's probably
not. See, no, really it is. You see, most don't know it, but 1989 Buicks were constructed with most of the required components. See, it's only as they age, Mahati, that the leaking fluids and oils are perfect for lubricating the time vortex. Boom!
Wow, that is, quite a story there.
It's very interesting.
I'm sure it's full of plot holes, too, so I'm just gonna get back to work.
Oh! Marty! Before you do that, take a look at this picture!
What am I supposed to be looking
for? Just look at it! Marty, look at the picture! Don't look around the picture! Look at the picture!
I'm looking at it. What am I supposed to look at?
You've gotta think fourth dimensionally!
What?
Our travels must have altered the present. You've disappeared completely from this photograph.
This is an ad for Nikon cameras. I wasn't in this to begin with.
Another close call. I'll have to be more careful with my family photos.
I can't see how that was a close call. Don't you think we should, you know, go somewhere or do something? We have a time machine sitting outside.
Well, you know, I've been walking.
I don't see what that has to do with anything. I was just saying we've got a car outside.
And I rode my bike places.
But we can time travel, Doc. We could
meet.
And what are you doing? You're here distracting me. You're here wrecking my car all the time.
Record winter in 1993. It's cold.
No, you're not touching this.
Logically speaking.
No,
yes.
No,
look at this photograph.
We already looked at the photo. Can you not? What do you call this? Ulcer. You're giving me an ulcer from all the stress. No, I'm just. For the love of God, I'm just trying to get this paper done. I just want to be finished with this, graduate. I quite frankly, never want to see you again, Doc. You're not a failure, Doc.
I'm a failure.
You're not a failure. You're just excessively overweight.
I'm a failure and a fat.
You just.
I'm a fatty fat fat.
Well.
You wrote it on your clipboard,
no,
body.
No, I didn't.
You wrote it on your clipboard.
I didn't. I did. You just eat McDonald's.
Thank you.
I'm gonna stab you, Doc.
I had mother issues.
Sit quietly. I sometimes just wish that you could speak in a sentence without being completely nonsensical.
Jane ran fast.
You know what else would be great? I'm just gonna take this.
The brainwave device, Marty!
No, I'm going to the time machine.
The waves, Marty, I need to test my brain.
No, I don't even know. I'm going out to the car, but please don't follow me.
Marty!
Don't follow me!
God, I better follow him. Marty! Wait up!
Touch the car? I thought we had a discussion about this earlier. You're not supposed to touch it.
I love it.
Just stay away from it. I don't even lean on it. Do you look at the state of these roads though, Doc? It's like they don't actually care that people have to drive on these things.
Where we're going, Marty? We don't need